Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Baron Kradna and Prince Dadian. This game was played in St. Petersburg in 1881. Baron Kradna had white pieces and he started with e4. Prince Dadian played e5, bishop to c4, the bishop's opening, knight to f6, and now d4. This is how Prince Dadian played his openings too. Black to move. Knight to c6 was played. d5. Let's take it back. Knight to f3 is the most played move. d5 was played, and it's such a tempting move. White is gaining the space on the board. However, on the negative side, the pawn is blocking his own bishop. The game continued. Knight to e7, knight to c3, knight to g6, bishop to g5, bishop to c5 before playing d6, knight to f3, d6, Baron Kradna castled kingside, bishop to g4, pinning the knight, h3. Black to move. What is the best pair for the bishop? Perhaps black should play bishop to d7. Prince Dadian played bishop to h5. White to move. Baron Kradna decided to play g4 and to trap the bishop. It is hard to resist that temptation, isn't it? g4, and the bishop is trapped. Black to move. Should black take on g4? And get two pawns for a piece. Prince Dadian played h6, attacking the bishop on g5, bishop takes on f6, not wasting any time. Black to move. How would you continue? Perhaps black should play queen takes on f6, and then castle queenside. Instead, Prince Dadian played g takes on f6. G takes on h5, white is a piece up, threatening to take another piece. Black to move. Knight to f4 was expected. Knight to f4 looks like a very natural move. Queen to d7 was played. Did Prince Dadian forget about his knight? H takes on g6. Queen to h3. This is the critical moment of the game. It is white to move. And Baron Kradna decided to simplify the game and to win in an easy endgame, he played knight to e2. Knight to h2 should have been considered. We have knight to e2. This was the idea. When queen takes on f3, then queen to d3. And if check, then queen to g3. Queen takes queen check. Knight takes on g3. White is better materially. And the position is very simple. It should be easy win for white. Back to our game. However, in this position, Prince Dadian found a killer move. Please pause and find the best move for black. Did you pause? What did you find? Prince Dadian played rook to g8. Knight to g3. Black played a move when white resigned, and the move is rook takes pawn. Baron Kradna resigned. There is no sensible defense against rook takes knight on g3 check. Mate, what do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.